Hello guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. So let me first introduce myself who just watching me for the first time. My name is Shatyam Jyotsna Gargi. If you want to know more about me, go comment, like and subscribe my channel. Okay? Either I'm not going to tell you anything. Sorry, this is a lame joke. You don't have to do it. Sorry, you have to do it. If you actually like the content, please go and do it. Okay? What's my preparation strategy? How I got it? Let's continue with the video and even just watch the whole video because I'm definitely going to give you some specific tips so that you can also nail your interview. It's totally based on my experience. I'm not going to say that the other people who just cracked the interview, this is the only thing they have to do. No, everyone has their strategy. This is my strategy, how I just nailed the interview. So yes, it all started I just want to divide this whole thing in four parts. First, the students who are eligible for this program, what are the things you have to prepare for this test? To clear the test, obviously, then you got on board on Engage. What are the things you have to do in Engage? And afterwards, what happened? It may be changed for next year, I don't know. But for this year, these all are the my experiences which I'm going to share with you. So, obviously, those students jinhone abhi सेकेंड ईयर मार्च में उनका खत्म होगा, मार्च एंड मे के टाइम पे, सो दे ऑल आर एलिजिबल फॉर दिस प्रोग्राम. एंड आफ्टरवर्ड्स फॉर द टेस्ट आई जस्ट आस्क फ्रॉम माई सीनियर्स एंड एट दैट टाइम दे ऑल्सो टोल्ड मी दैट यू हैव टू एटलीस्ट स्टडी सर्चिंग सॉर्टिंग बिकॉज दीज आर द थिंग्स विच दे आर गोइंग टू आस्क द मोस्ट इन दियर टाइम ऑल्सो. सो इवन इन माई टाइम ऑल्सो आई फाइंड सम बेसिक क्वेश्चन ऑल्सो बट सर्चिंग एंड सॉर्टिंग आर देयर. सो येस यू जस्ट कम्प्लीट विद द बेसिक DSA एंड आफ्टरवर्ड्स ऑब्वियसली आई गॉट सेलेक्टेड फॉर दिस प्रोग्राम. आई वॉन्ट दैट यू ऑल्सो गॉट सेलेक्टेड एंड देन आई जस्ट गॉट ऑन बोर्ड विद द Engage. एंड Engage बेसिकली वॉट यू हैव टू डू इज लाइक you have to work on a project using web development, app development is totally your choice. So I can suggest you one thing. Like before March only, you just learn at least web development or app development. Just basic only, you don't have to be pro. If you are a pro, then that is a great thing that obviously going to nail at that time. And then I have quite basic knowledge of app development. So it's just a kind of strong point for me. Like I just started this project using the app development and I just learned a lot of things. And one more specific point I want to give you that during the whole process, be just so communicative with your mentors. Even if you do some specific change in your project now, just go and tell them and like do a mail to the mentors regularly, tell them about the updates and be vocal about the features you are going to implement. In the starting, you just made a documentation and just made them realize that there are the things you are going to do from your own side. In this project, what are the things we have to build is like, you have to basically made a video calling app. Like, two people can do video call with each other. This is a very simple feature, but they also told that the people who are going to make more number of feature in this app or like web, wherever you just comfortable to make, they are going to get like more marks. So for me also, like I just made 6 to 7 extra feature like video conferencing, audio calling and all that. You can check out my project in the previous video. I just also uploaded that project and please go and check it out. I just literally like 14-15 take for making that video. Even this video, this is the 5th time I'm recording this. Sometime I lost the video or something. That is a whole different story. I'm so leave that. So yes, afterwards I'm so confident. Like on 14th I just submit my project and I was like, I just keep my 100%. Even during the whole season I just barely sleep for 5 to 6 hours. Like I can say that because I just wake up and like took my laptop and start working on solving the errors and all that kind of stuff. So yeah, it's a kind of hectic. And afterwards I didn't study for 7 days. And because I think that I am going to get the direct internship, I don't know from where this confidence come in myself at that time, and this is totally not good. Yes, but yes, this not happened. Like even on 22 I got a mail that you have like interviewer scheduled from 22, and yes, things are going in this way. And I was like, my mind is literally blown up. Like I didn't study DSA for last 1 month. So if you can able to study DSA with the program when the whole 1 month is going, you just invested all your energy in that program. If you have time to study DSA, then please do it. because as the program over na, even campus internship and all those things going to start. So please just do with the DSA concept. So yes, afterwards I have my interview scheduled, and like then I revise, then I start revising the concept, take some tips from the seniors that how, like what is the question that was specifically going to ask by Microsoft. And I can also told you before going to sit for an interview, like whatever company it is, please go and ask from the seniors, because they have a very good experience and they can share the experience, and that will really help you. Because at that time I also have barely 4 or 5 days. I know that I'm not going, at that time I'm not going to complete whole DSA and all that kind of thing. Basically I can revise some specific topic, and that all I do. Even I practice a lot on the, like how you have to speak yourself, how you have to communicate during the whole interview and all that, and this literally pops out in the whole interview. So yes, afterwards my interviewer is so strict. I don't know, like I'm like so excited, I'm kind of so confident person, I just go with so much confident, like yes, I'm going to nail it. But my interviewer was so strict and I just literally got a little nervous, I can say that. But yes, it just goes out well. And afterwards the interview, I'm like quite more confident, like yes man, I just give my 100% in this interview also. I just prepare day and night for all the DSA revising, all the concept, making all the specific questions that are basically asked by the Microsoft. And I just prepare not only on the technical part, also on the like whole everything, because Microsoft ye nahi dekhta hai aap technical kitne acche ho, wo dekhta hai ki aap overall kitne acche ho, like aapki speaking skill kya hai, aap communicate kaise karte ho, how you just take your whole interview. And interview aap pe depend karta hai, aap isko kidhar leke jana chahte ho, right? So yes, afterwards, like as I told you, मैं बहुत confident थी यार मेरा तो हो रहा है. And even same thing, I just repeated the same mistake. I didn't study for next 4 to 5 days. I don't know why, but there is a very I can say that there is a vast breakdown happened at that time. Like still I didn't get a rejection mail, I didn't got a selection mail. Like I'm confused, like why is this happening with me? Every time I just give my 100% and I didn't able to get the result. आपके साथ भी ऐसा होता होगा, लाइक कभी कभी आप बहुत मेहनत करते हो किसी चीज़ के लिए एंड उसका जब रिजल्ट कुछ नहीं आता, देन यू ऑल्सो फील बैड. सेम हैपन विथ मी, आई कॉन्ट डू एनीथिंग एट दैट टाइम. इवन कैंपस प्लेसमेंट स्टार्ट हो रहा था मेरे यहाँ 14 से, देन आई हैव टू प्रिपेयर फॉर दैट ऑल्सो, बट आई कॉन्ट डू एनीथिंग. लाइक आई एम जस्ट टोटली जस्ट सफरिंग, आई कैन से ट्रामा, नॉट ट्रामा इज अ बिग वर्ड, लाइक इज दैट अ काइंड ऑफ टेंशन दैट इधर माइक्रोसॉफ्ट में इतना मेहनत की नहीं हुआ, अब फिर से स्टार्ट करो, फिर से चीजें स्टार्ट करो, फिर से पढ़ो. But somehow I can say that on 10th I got to know from somewhere that Microsoft is visiting our campus on 21st and they are going to interview all the engaged students. Like directly they have to interview all the engaged students. So I just make a whole strategy. So what's my strategy? You can also follow this strategy. Maybe it will help you out also, because many person have different strategy to crack my interview. So my strategy is basically I just go and talk from 20 to 25 people on LinkedIn. I literally message them by making a template to please tell me about your experiences and all, and they share their experiences, and like I literally get a lot of knowledge from their side, and I know that how my interview is going to be. I just make a whole frame of all that. So what I did is, like whatever they are sharing their experiences, they are going to talk about the HR question, I just make a note, I just wrote the every question. That question are I think 27 to 30 question. And even I just write about my project also, like what are the things which I have to say about my project, because I want myself to align with everything, because I know that na my DSA and like that competitive coding and all is quite low, so I have to level up this part. Because if Microsoft is going to judge you on the whole part, so if some part is going to be down, then other part have to be perfect, right? So I just search for each in a specific question, like how's your introduction going to be, and what are the things, specific skill which Microsoft want, that they want a student kind of learner, and their nature are kind of like empowering people and like empowering their environment, growth nature, yeah. So these are the specific key point which I added in when I'm introducing myself. And afterwards I can share you one more tip, that when you are going to give interview for any company, I can say any company, this is not specific about Microsoft, please make a note and search a lot more about that specific company. You get to just, you have some idea about that company, what on what tech stack this company is going to, like is working and all that, like kya kya news aaya us company ke bare mein pehle ya fir idhar kya kya news mein chal raha hai. Just go check out all that, you get to know a lot more from there, yes I can say. And afterwards, obviously, these are the things which really pops out my interview. So my interview, because I just frame my interview in my way and it just go in that way only. I know that interviewer come and ask me this question, how I have to nail this question. In the first half only, I just impressed him so that he can understand it. Like, yes, he has all that quality. And then he comes on my technical part. My technical part, I can say that in the first interview also, in the second interview also, my technical part is not that much great. I didn't give the perfect answer to every question. But yes, like I can say that 60-40, yes. Like 60% correct, 40% wrong also. But when I ask the question that is specific about the company, it just literally pop out. The interviewer is quite happy and they also appreciate me for this specific question. So even your whole interview is kind of this now. You can do some specific thing from your side, right? By learning about the company and all that, they just level up your interview. Yes, so ye sab ho gaya. Uske baad like I just got the internship. Like even at that time, I'm also confident. I don't know why. Even I'm getting that interview, even I'm not getting that interview. I know that if mujhe nahi mila, fir se mujhe prepare karna. But you can't say anything. If your destiny take you there na, if yahan likha hai, kuch nahi kar sakte aap. So yes, this is my whole journey. And if you want to know a lot more about, like, I'm from ECE department and how I switch my career to CSE department, how it all started, you can comment on the comment section. I'm definitely going to reply. Even if you want to make a video on all that, I'm definitely going to make. And just point out my mistake which I did in this video. It really will help me to improve myself. Yes, bye bye. See you on next video.